This week I had a customer ask me how they can import their existing configuration from within the NSX GUI into Terraform. I've set up a simple tier zero configuration inside my browser, and we'll import that into Terraform to show you how that's done. Now, it's not as straightforward as you might think. Terraform can import existing objects from within NSX and other third-party devices as well, but it will import the entire configuration of that object, which often includes things that are pre-computed inside NSX, for example, values that do not need to be constantly updated, and it will import the entire configuration state as well. So all the default values will be present. So quite often there's a lot of unneeded things that need to be removed. Once you've done this a few times, it's pretty obvious which ones need to be removed from the configuration, but we'll go through and we'll show you how that's done. I've built a tier zero router here inside my lab environment called peering. If you watched my videos before, I quite often have a tier zero that is my peering router to peer into my lab environment using BGP. So if you look at my config here, I'll just close this all down here. Called peering. I've got a couple of additional settings here. I normally have EVPN configuration in place as well, which is probably not that standard, with an EVPN VXLAN tunnel endpoint as well, and a pre-configured VXLAN VNI pool. I have two interfaces configured, a loopback interface, which I use for multi-hop BGP peering into a Cisco router, and another interface, which is called peering as well, which will be doing EBGP peering into my MicroTik router in my lab. I do have some route redistribution configured. I have two BGP neighbors, one of which is up and one's down at the moment. I have OSPF configured as well, and obviously I have some route redistribution configured. So this entire config was created through the GUI. There was no external API calls made or Terraform used to configure and build this tier zero. So to import this into Terraform, we have to define a new file. So I'll make a new file here called peering zero Terraform. And then we need to define all the resources we want to import. So I've built this already, and I'll just cut and paste here as well. So all the resources that need to be imported. So we need to import a resource that's a tier zero gateway. And all of this is documented on the Terraform.io website. So I'm just going to take this here and jump back into my browser and we'll search for that. So the definition of this resource is documented here at Terraform, and here's an example configuration. But if we scroll to the bottom of this page, we'll see the requirements to actually import an existing one. So I need to already have defined in my Terraform plan file a tier zero gateway. And this part here is the name of that gateway. That's in the file, and this ID component here, which is described below, is the referencing the ID of the tier zero gateway within inside NSX itself, which happens to also be called peering. So inside my example file here, I've already created the commands you need to run to have Terraform go away and import the value, the response from the peering object here in NSX, and import it into this value which we defined in this file here, which is this element here. So we then get the returning response from Terraform, which is populated into the state file. We take that configuration file and we use that to update this template with the values we have imported. So I'm going to go through. What I'm going to do is I'm going to comment these out here, and then I'm going to push this up into my environment. Right, so let's just synchronize this back into GitHub. Right, so we'll pull that file down. So we now have this new file, so let's have a look at it. Right, so I'm going to take this command here. Good to keep track of these commands as well. So I'm going to tell Terraform to go away and import this value into this resource here. Right. So we do a Terraform state, because this imports the current network state into the computed Terraform state file. And we'll list all the resources it knows about, and we'll find the one that looks like this. So T0 T0 gateway theorem, this one here. Right? And we'll show that one. This is going to show you the Terraform syntax of all the resources. I'm going to cut and paste this here. I'm going to jump back into Visual Studio. I'm going to paste that into here. Right, so I'm going to run this as it is. And we'll see it's going to complain about a bunch of these values here, which it considers to be unneeded. Often these things are internally held and computed with inside NSX. And this is the same for other third-party devices you're importing as well. Save that one. So now we're going to run a Terraform plan against this, and it's going to object to a bunch of things inside here as well. So it doesn't like some of the deprecated values it sees here. We never need to have these IDs here as well, and the paths can be removed as well as the revisions. So first thing it's complaining about is this force whitelisting statement, this ID statement here. We've got a path statement here, a revision here. Right, so we'll save this. Okay, this time we've got no objections, so it's happy with that configuration file and the syntax. So we'll go through and we'll do the same thing for another group of these files here, all these resources here. So let's go through and maybe go all the way down to here. I'm just excluding these ones here so we can make sure we can see what needs to be removed when we do the imports. Right, so the command in my file is this one. So you can see the ID is just one appearing. Do that one. And we're going to want to grab this. And then again, we take this value here and we cut and paste it back into here. We remove this ID, we remove this path, and I think that's all we need to do. So while we're here, we'll grab this one. All right, and we'll grab this interface, dump the config, open the Visual Studio, there's a revision here as well. We don't need this either from memory. And we'll try this one next as well. And again, we'll grab this. save that. Didn't look like on the screen also, added interfaces. Save that. Okay, let's push this up as well. So now we've added our VTAP interface and our two interfaces. There's a few things. Okay, we need to go back and remove a few of these things as well. So I'll just jump back in here. Okay, so it looks like I missed line 59. And you don't need these locale service IDs. Now, it looks like it's going to need the VTAP interface as well for this to work, so I didn't grab that one, so grab that one. Grab that config. There's a few dependencies here on some of this. Cut and paste that output into here. Now we don't need that interview either. We don't need this path. I think that should do it. Okay, two more things we got wrong. Okay, quickly fix that. So the gateway ID on line 87, don't need that, and the ID for the call VTAP monkey. Should have got rid of that one before. Should have nothing to object about now. Okay, great. Let's just apply it and see what happens if we apply it. Okay, and it should say there's nothing to be done. Okay, fantastic. Now we'll jump back into Visual Studio. The last two things we have to grab are the BGP neighbors. So inside here, to grab the ID, we actually have to get the UUID. Now to do that, there's actually a command we can run using a tool like curl, or we can use Postman to actually go away and extract the existing configuration for BGP neighbors. I'll show you what that looks like. We jump into Postman here as well. I've already run this command here. Let's just refresh that. And we can look through and grab this display name here, this ID, which actually is the same as the display name. And this is what we reference to import the configuration. So I'm just going to, now I've commented these out, I'm just going to save this. To import the config, so the Terraform import command will look like this based on the ID I've extracted using Terraform. Sorry, Postman. Right, great. And again, we grab this config here. Grab all the config. Jump back into Visual Studio, I'll paste this just here. Now, I'm fairly sure we can get rid of that. And get rid of this. We can get rid of the maximum routes. And we'll try that. And we'll grab the other one as well. And back to our terminal. I bet you I've missed something. Right. And we'll have to look at the config for this one. Again, copy this. Paste this in here. I've actually got to get rid of that BGP path. ID can go. Oop. Save that. Save that. Now, which things did I miss? Oh, I told you it's a path. All right, back into Visual Studio, let's just grab the path, not the BGP path. This one here. And this one here. Save that. Let's see if it's happy this time. It is. Right, so no changes needed. Right, let's try and make a change. So jump back into our browser, have a look at our, obviously our router is called Peering. Let's see if we can change the name. Now we're managing things through Terraform. I'll change the name of the router to BGP Peering. Save this. Save that. Push that back there. Pull down my config here. Run a plan and it'll tell us what the difference is going to be. Okay, great. So it's saying here that display name is going to go from peering to BGP peering. Apply that change. Yes, we're going to make that change. Jump back into our browser, let's do a refresh. Cool, it's now called BGP peering. So all the configurations now are fully maintained by Terraform through my plan file. So moving forward, I should be monitoring or maintaining this through Terraform. So it is possible to create objects through NSX in the GUI and then import them into Terraform. It's not as straightforward, but once you've done it a few times, it's pretty easy to work out which attributes need to be removed from the configuration file so they can be successfully pushed back and synchronized. If you have any questions, let me know. I'm happy to try out different scenarios and see how we can actually make Terraform work for you guys with NSX. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.